Today's Mass, the month's mind Mass for the souls of Teresa Rodrigues, Sharon Ignatius de Silva, Xavier Chetiar, and Dominic Serrao, also being the first death anniversary for the soul of Thomas Castellino and Winifred de Silva, and all the intentions in the Mass intentions box. For our entrance hymn, we'll take beginning today, My Morning Sayos. Please join in.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus has said, wherever two or three are gathered in my name, there I am. With faith in God, his providence and his presence in our midst today, with great delight and joy in our hearts, let us all sign ourselves. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us all pray in silence. Set our hearts aflame, O Lord, with the spirit of your charity, we pray, that we may always think thoughts worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you sincerely in our brothers and sisters, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. You have probably heard how I have entrusted by God with the grace he meant for you, and that it was by a revelation that I was given the knowledge of the mystery, as I have just described it very shortly. If you read my words, you will have some idea of the depth that I see in the mystery of Christ. This mystery that has now been revealed through the Spirit to his holy apostles and prophets was unknown to any men in past generations. It means that pagans now share the same inheritance, that they were a part of the same body, and that The same promise has been made to them in Christ Jesus through the gospel. I have been made the servant of that gospel by the gift of grace from God, who gave it to me by his own power. I, who am less than the least of all the saints, have been entrusted with this special grace, not only of proclaiming to the pagans the infinite treasure of Christ, but also of explaining how the mystery is to be dispensed. Through all the ages, this has been kept hidden in God, the creator of everything. Why? So that the sovereignty and powers should learn only now, through the church, how comprehensive God's wisdom really is, exactly according to the plan which he had from all eternity in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is why we are bold enough to approach God in complete confidence through our faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response after every psalm will be,
you will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
All together.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Truly, God is my salvation. I trust I shall not fear. For the Lord is my strength, my song. He becomes my savior. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord, give praise to his name. Make his mighty deeds known to the peoples. Declare the greatness of his name. Sing a psalm to the Lord.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Kindly stand. Stay awake and stand ready, because you do not know the hour when the Son of Man is coming.
Alleluia, 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 praise ye the Lord. Alleluia, 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 praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord, alleluia, praise ye.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O God.
Jesus said to his disciples, you may be quite sure of this, that if the householder had known at what hour the burglar would come, he would not have let anyone break through the wall of his house. You too must stand ready, because the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Peter said, Lord, do you mean this parable for us or for everyone? The Lord replied, what sort of steward then is faithful and wise enough for the master to place him over his household to give them their allowance of food at the proper time? Happy that servant if his master's arrival finds him at this employment. I tell you truly, he will place him over everything he owns. But as for the servant who says to himself, my master is taking his time coming, and sets about beating the men, servants and the maids, and eating and drinking and getting drunk, his master will come on a day he does not expect, and at an hour he does not know. The master will cut him off and send him to the same fate as the unfaithful. The servant who knows what his master wants, but has not even started to carry out those wishes, will receive very many strokes of the lash. The one who did not know, but deserves to be beaten for what he has done, will receive fewer strokes. When a man has had a great deal given him, a great deal will be demanded of him. When a man has had a great deal given him on trust, even more will be expected of him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, I will use this mic. There seems to be some technical problem. So please permit me to give my reflection from the altar. Dear brothers and sisters, fear is not from God. And if we allow fear to come in our lives, fear will freeze us, we will become stagnant, it will not allow us to move forward, but fear will always pull us backward. In this pandemic that we are, a lot of us may have a lot of fears. Fear about the present, fear about the future, fear about losing jobs, fear about financial crisis, fear about providing for the family. As Christians, when we hear about the end time, when we hear about death, when we hear about the second coming of God, the second coming, parousia, it may cause some fear in our hearts. For Christians, and who say that Jesus is our Lord and Master, there should be no fear. A true Christian has faith. A true Christian has perseverance in his life. A true Christian is vigilant, prepared, ever ready. The gospel today very specifically speaks about being prepared, being vigilant, being ever ready. So prepared and ever ready for what? To meet the Lord. But when does the Lord come to us? Does the Lord comes to us only when we die and we meet him face to face? Will the Lord come to us only during the second coming, the parousia? My dear brothers and sisters, what we have failed to understand and recognize in our Christian life is God comes to us very often while we live our life here on earth. So we are called to be prepared not only for the second coming, not only when we die and we meet the Lord face to face, but we are called to be prepared every day because we don't know when God will come to us, and he comes to us very often through different situations, through different people and strangers and events in our lives. And when he comes to us, we are called to be prepared. We are called to be ever ready. What does it mean to be prepared? What does it mean to be ever ready? It simply means to be faithful to the instructions of Jesus. And what have been the instructions of Jesus? To love, to forgive, to serve, to share. In the last part of the gospel, it is said, if God has given you a great deal is expected of us. So if God loves us, if God has given us forgiveness in great deal, God expects the same from you and me. To love others, to forgive them. And if he has given us something on trust and with responsibility, more is expected. For example, if you and I have been given by God a lot of riches, and in that sense, if we use those riches, that wealth, only for ourselves, then we are more accountable. Because whatever God has given us, it is given to us with trust. It is given to us with greater responsibility to bring glory to God for our own good and especially for the good of the poor. So God calls us to be ever ready, following his instructions, doing great things with trust and responsibility that he has entrusted to us with. So my dear brothers and sisters, while we are present here for this Eucharist, let us remind ourselves, we are called to be ready every moment of our life. Every breath that we breathe, we are called to be prepared to meet the Lord and to be ready. Let's close our eyes, spend some moments in reflection, and ask of God's grace to be ever ready. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify these gifts in your mercy, O Lord, and accepting the oblation of the spiritual sacrifice, grant, we pray, that we may extend your charity to all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy Lord, Holy Lord, Lord God of hosts. Holy Lord, Holy Lord, Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in his name, Hosanna in the highest. Holy Lord, Holy Lord, Lord God of hosts. Holy Lord, Holy Lord, Lord God of hosts.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With faith, with perseverance, and being ever ready and prepared, let us say together the prayer that Jesus himself taught. Together we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamp of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamp of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamp of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
This is Jesus, his life, his teachings, his passion, and his death reminds us of being ever ready, of being prepared. Happy are all of us who are called to the banquet of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy
to receive
that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us make our spiritual communion with our Lord. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Please join in singing All the Ends of the Earth.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. Oh, the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song of the Lord, the wonders he has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for
So faith, hope, and charity remain these three. But the greatest of these is charity. Let us all stand and continue to pray in silence. Pour out the grace of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, on those you have replenished with the one bread of heaven, and refresh us, we pray, with the delights of perfect charity, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
the coronavirus prayer. We pray together for God's protection against the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us prepare ourselves for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Do not be afraid. Be ever ready. Together, thanks be to God.
In the last week, we had the baptism of the following children. Noah D'Souza, born to Robin and Ivy. Haley Mirelle Pinto, born and baptized. Parents Carl and Alicia. And Xander Dias, baptized. Parents Clayton and Tina. We shall take the last hymn. Please join in. Go into the world.
I tell you now, go proclaim, I give to you my spirit's flame. He is at work inside of you to overcome all the powers of darkness.
Spirit.